Today we are going to discuss about recorders. So how many types of recorders are there? What are all their functionalities? So I'm going to click on new here. My first recorder is smart recorder. So smart recorder is help us to automate the desktop applications. Okay, so for suppose, let me go with you. So here it is asking, it is showing the lot of desktop windows here. No, it will help us to automate the desktop operation. So now I want to automate the calculator. Okay, I open calculator.
Is it recording?
Yes.
Okay.
So I open the calculator. Now I'm refreshing it. So now it will display over here. See, here I'm able to see the calculator. I'm starting. So now I'm clicking on the start button. So now what I'll do? So just I want to perform one sum. So here I'm clicking on 5. Then I'm clicking on the addition button. So that means plus. So now I'm clicking over here 31. Now I'm giving equals. So it's become 36. Now here, if you see here, I'm stopping the recorder. Now I'm saving this one as smart recorder. I saved this one. It's all automatically open in edit mode. So basically here the smart recorder has been saved. Now I made the value of the CALC is 0. Now I'm selecting this smart recorder task and now I'm running. Equals to task. So the task has been performed automatically. So the simple thing is, so with the help of the recorders, just you need to start the recording and you need to perform the manual operation. So then the recorder will record all steps and that can be performed automatically. See here, just I haven't done anything, simply just I have switched on the smart recorder and I recorded every flow. After that, just simply I closed that one, right? That means I canceled that recording and I saved it. So after saving that, when I run the task, whatever I perform manually, the same operation has been replicated automatically. So that's how recorders will help us. So let me open this editing. Here, if you see, all the commands has been captured automatically here. These are all called object cloning commands. We will discuss about these object cloning in coming classes. But here, nothing is. All commands has been captured. So that's how the smart recorder will work. Next, what is the next type of recorder? So basically here the smart recorder will help you to automate the desktop applications. Next we'll discuss about web recorder. Later on we'll go with the screen recorder at last. Now let's go with the web recorder. So I'm selecting the web recorder. Here I have to give the UR. So basically, what's this URL? So first of all, I want to automate the Facebook. At the time, I need to give the Facebook URL. I want to automate the Twitter. I need to give the Twitter URL. So I want to automate some other web application. So at that time, I need to give that web application URL. So what is the web application? So it's desktop application that will be inside your machine. That can be called as desktop application. The web application is an application that will be installed in some other server, and you will be able to access that one with the help of one URL. Okay. So for suppose Facebook is an application which has been installed in Facebook company servers. So you haven't installed that in your local machine, but still you are able to access that with the help of Facebook URL called www.facebook.com. So this kind of applications can be called as web recorders. For suppose MS Office suit, the MS Word or MS Excel, or suppose this calculator which we discussed earlier. All these applications has been installed in your machine. So these kind of applications can be called as desktop applications. So now I want to automate one web recorder. Okay. So I want to automate one website. So let me go here. Let me take. Okay, we'll do the simple thing first. That one will go with deep. So just I want to open the Google and I have to search for the automation. So now I'm saying www.google.com. So now I'm clicking on start. So just click on OK. So you need to wait until website is loaded completely. If you see, the Google page came, but here still it is loading. Now it has been opened completely. So now I'm going to click on this search button. So once I read this one here, I'll ask, what is automation anyway? So I'm removing typo happen. So now I'm giving enter. Now I'm going to click on Google search. It's gave the results. So I'm stopping this recorder, and here I'll say web recorder. Save this. So now I'm closing this browser window. So it has been closed. Now I have selected this web recorder and I'm starting running this. Automatically it's performed the same operation on top of the web application. Okay. Like this web recorder will work. Next, the web recorder. I'll show you one scenario. So this is a Yahoo Finance website. So here all company shares and their values are there, right? So I need to capture all this list from here. Okay. Now again, I'm going with new and I'm taking web recorder. So here I am giving that Yahoo Finance URL over here. So now I'm clicking on start. Now here I'm clicking on extract data and I am selecting pattern based data. See, what is this pattern based data? So if you observe these values here, see, all are similar type of data. This one, this S&P 500 and Dow 30 and NASDAQ, all these are similar kind of data. So this is a similar kind of data, but not the same data, right? So all are following the same pattern. So all the fonts is same, all the colors are same, all the format also same, right? Over here. So now I want to capture all these things and want to save into a Excel file. Okay. See, here I want to first capture the company name. So if you go and put the cursor over here, 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 you see it is highlighting with the green colors, right? So I am selecting the S&P 500. So I am clicking on this. So then it will give this pop-up window. Here you have to select the capture. Now you have to capture one more control which is similar to this S&P 50. Okay. So now I am selecting the, you can select anything from here. So whether DOW 30 or NASDAQ or this one, Russell and Russell 2000, all these things. So I am selecting this one. Now the bot is able to understood all these controls belongs to one format. That's the reason we need to capture two similar controls. Then it will able to understood, okay, all these are following same pattern, right? So here I'm giving ORG, so organization, save. So now organizations has been captured. Now along with that, I need to capture the their value as well. So I'm clicking on add. See here, I'm clicking on the value. So now it's give the capture. Now I'm giving, clicking on capture. Now again, I have to provide the similar kind of data to the bot. So now I'm clicking on second option. So now it has been captured. So here I'll say well, means value. So next, clicking on next. Again, I'm going to next. Here, I have to browse. I want to save the data, right? So I'll go with the documents, automation anywhere files, automation anywhere, my docs. Here RPM matrix, here I'll share this. So here I'll save this with the name of Yahoo underscore. So the supported format for this one is CSV. So you need to save with the CSV only. So I'm clicking on move. So I'm clicking on finish. Now I am stopping the recorder here. So I'm stopping it. Web recorder. Good. Pattern data. Okay. So now I'm going to run this. Let's go and see. Okay. Here I'm going to my docs, RPA, Yahoo Finance, has been created. Of course, you may not see the all those operations because of the automation in your suite, but it's performed all operations. See here, organization value, and it's give all the list of values. Like this, you will able to capture pattern data of any website. This is the procedure to capture the pattern data. Next, let me go. So simply I'm going to Google here. I'm searching for the list of states in India. So I'm clicking on the first URL. Let's check. Yeah, this is the Maps of India website. So here all the list of states are there, right, in India. So I want to extract these states. Okay. So this is also web application. So in this web application, we have a table. Okay. Now I want to extract this table. Let's see how we can do this. So I'm copying this URL. I'm closing this IE. Again, I'm going with a new command and I am selecting web recorder. Here I'm giving that URL from where I need to extract the table. I'm clicking on start. Now I'm clicking on the OK. Done, right? So now here I'm going to select extract table. Once I clicked on the extract table button here, see, this capture is enabled. So now I'm putting the cursor over here, all the places, but these are not identifying, right, with the green color. Of course, this is identifying with the green color. Of course, it's a table, but this is not our requirement. So I'm just scrolling down. So here my table came. See, once I put the cursor on this control, it is highlighted with the green color. That means this particular table has been identified as a web table. Okay. So now simply I'm giving a click. So all the data has been captured. If you see, all 39 has been captured. I'm clicking on next button. Here I'm browsing states list. I'm saving, and now I'm finishing this. Now I'm stopping the recorder. Yeah, I'll say web recorder check table. Save this. Now I'm going to run this. Let me go here. If you see here, this is my record. There is no file called as a states list here. Now just I'm going to this client. Let me close this window as well. So simply I'm going to RPA matrix folder here. I'm going to select the web recorder extract table, and now I'm running this. So it has been captured. Let's go and see. Here the stateslist.csv has been created. See here, all the details has been captured here. So like this, you will able to extract the tables from website. So this is about web recorder. Next. First, suppose earlier in the earlier example, in the first web recorder example, I'm searching for the automation anyway, right? What is automation anyway? But I did a mistake. There just I want to search for what is automation anyway university. So instead of that, I have searched the what is automation anyway. So I want to change it. So I'm going to here see. Okay, here web recorder. I'm editing this in the edit mode. So here. These comments has been created. So here I am editing this command search text with what is automation anyway. Okay, I'm editing this particular command. So here I'm going to advanced view. See here. Here my question is what is automation anyway. So but actually it should be what is automation anyway. Okay, this is my question. So at that time I forgot that one. So this is a scenario. Okay, so if you want to change the search condition or search criteria, you can edit the task and you can modify the search criteria in this way. Now I'm running this. Let me close this one. So earlier that was this bot is searching for the what is automation anyway, but now it is going to search for what is automation anyway university. See, now it has been searching for what is automation any university. So like this you can modify. Okay, in the same way, the earlier example, smart recorder. Here also, I'm editing this. Here you are performing the sum operation, right? So between 5 and 31. But my requirement is I don't want to go with the 5, I want to go with the 9. So I'm editing this. See here. Here the name is there, right? So simply I'm making this one as nine. Okay. Thing. Let me open the calculator here. See, it's clicked on 9 plus 31. So, like this, you can change the values. So, this is about smart recorder and web recorder. Now let's go with the screen recorder. Okay, so what we can do is I'm going here and I'm selecting new. And I'm selecting screen recorder. So once I have selected the screen recorder, I am opening this window. So file explore window, and here I'm selecting a, and that means I'm double clicking states list. So it has been captured. And now I'm closing this states list. Now I'm stopping this screen recorder. So here the question is, in which situation we'll go with the screen recorder? Okay, for suppose the web recorder or smart recorder is not going to help you to automate any particular application, at that time you'll go with the screen recorder. Okay, sometimes what will be happen, for suppose you are automating a desktop application, but whenever you go with the smart recorder, that is not working as expected. Suppose, assume this is the situation. Okay, at that time you will go with the screen recorder. Saying this, okay, I'm running this one. Opening the states list. Now it will go on. See, let me open and show you this in edit mode, the screen recorder. So screen recorder is a blind recorder. See, if you go with web recorder, here also this one is know what it's going to do. So here that's the reason it is showing. Okay, so open URL. So here it can know all the commands what it can do. Here also same one. So it is able to identify, okay, I'm clicking on 9 and I'm clicking on plus and I'm clicking on 3 and I'm clicking on 1 and I'm clicking on equals, like this. Here also, if you go here, it can say, okay, I'm opening the Google site, and here I'm searching for the automation in your university, and here I'm clicking for the Google search button, if you see here. So these commands are, that means these recorders are able to understood what they are doing exactly. But when it comes to the screen recorder, this is a blind one. It don't know anything actually what it is doing. So simply it will go to that particular location on the screen and it will perform the operation whatever you want. See, here it is, this one is don't know what it is doing basically. Okay, simply it is going to this particular location on your screen. So this x-axis and this y-axis, so it is going to particular position on your screen and it is performing the operation. If you click on advanced view, here left button, click or double click, like this it will be. So it will go blindly. For suppose now I am using the 15 inches monitor, so on this particular location I have this one. See, now what I'll do is I'm changing this one, okay, in my machine only. So now I'm going to run this. See, it is opening Opera. So that is the problem with the screen recorder. So this is a blind one. This one don't know what it is doing exactly. Okay, so that is the reason using the screen recorder is not recommended. Okay, but still if you believe, okay, the other recorders are not going to help me, and I am going to run my task in the same mission with the same positions, with the same screen and same configuration, at that time you can try the screen recorder. Okay, but if you deploy the same code in another mission, that is not going to work, particularly about screen recorder. Remaining recorders will work on any mission, but the screen recorder, if you go with the screen recorder, you need to use the same mission whenever you are going to run that automation. So that is the thing about the screen recorder. So this is about recorders.